Hello and welcome back to Thurrock Plays Blood Bowl 2. We are due for another Lizardmen match, and I really should try to figure out a different way to start these episodes, because I always start with what we're up for next, and by now you all know the drill, I guess, so I don't know. We'll see. So, as always, a quick look at our team before we get started. We are missing Underbite today, so no Frenzy with us, unfortunately. But at least we do have all of our other Sauri, and I bought a new Skink, so that we are back up to 12 for now, but we will of course only have 11 players for this match. Our team value is still at 1450, and that's basically it, so we can find an opponent and see what will happen. So it's about 3.5 minutes, something like that, so we will be right back once I get assigned an opponent, so see you in a moment. And here we go. So this is an odd one. We get pitched against a fresh Lizardmen team, I guess. Although 1000 team value speaks of at least one match. No result. Okay, so what is he missing? Oh, he is only 4 Sauri and a Crox. And he just gave up. Okay. Not unexpected, I'd say. But still unfortunate. Oh well. So, we've got the MVP on Osaurus as well as our new Skink, so both of them are close to leveling up again. This, of course, puts us in the nice position that Underbite is now available again. And I can actually buy one more Skink, so I'll need to look up a name real quick here. Let me choose a head first. Just the standard one is fine, I think. I'm not sure if we have that one at the moment or not, but it's fine. So one moment, please. And we are back, so I've chosen name. We are going to buy that player, confirm the purchase. Now we're back up to 13. And can go looking for our next match. So team value is actually pretty decent again, and the next match will probably be against a different opponent or a different kind of opponent. So yeah, once again, about 3 minutes wait time, so we'll be right back. And here we go again. So Necromantic again. Our team AO is 300 lower than or higher than theirs. Not sure if this means he plays mostly in leagues or if he is a fairly new player. We'll see about that. So what does he have? 1 cheerleader, 1 coach assistant, 3 rerolls. That's pretty standard. Block dodge. Block a guard white, a wrestle ghoul, block zombie. Block dauntless. Yes, okay. That guy is a bit of a nuisance, I guess. And a sure hands ghoul. Okay, pretty decent so far, so this, we'll see what he does with this. So I assume a wizard, a babe, and a bribe. That's probably what I would go for. But we'll see. And I didn't actually check his bench, so how many players he has. But probably not more than 13. He might go for 14 if he's very foul happy, but he doesn't have a dirty player, where he could have one. With these zombies. So I don't know. And let's just check that real quick, actually. So it's 6, 7, 8, 11 players just. So every injury we can deal to him will be very helpful as long as he doesn't regenerate. And he does have 2 ghouls, so we do have some decent targets to hit. Especially the sure hands one. We don't have tackle, if I remember correctly. Yep, wizard, babe, and bribe. Nope, Igor. Makes sense as well. It's a little bit safer than the bribe. And then Igor is basically the necromantic or the regeneration team equivalent of the extra apothecary. So we can re-roll a regeneration roll with that, I think. But he's not completely convinced about that yet, apparently. So he removed it for now again. I don't have tackle, do I? Nope, I do. I have frenzy, though. Or extra reroll? Huh? I would probably still opt for the bribe. But I don't know. He also has 10k too much of his own money. Oh, he's going for two babes and spend some of his own money. So his team value should be 10 lower. In this case, it doesn't matter too much. I guess. Because 310,000 still wouldn't have changed too much. But if it would have been 290,000, it would have made a difference, of course. At least if you're unwilling to spend some of your own money, which he wasn't in this case. But going for two babes here might not be the worst idea for him. He gets to choose, and he's going on defense first? Okay. Interesting. I didn't expect that. Okay, so no bench on his behalf. So we are playing against Nerudalum, if you pronounce it like that. Once again, I apologize if I butcher names, and his team is called Krakos. Okay, what do we need to look out for? As always, of course, we have to be careful with getting surfed, because the werewolves do have frenzy. But we might also let them, or we could be able to let them run into frenzy traps, if we are careful. So we'll see. Is he going to put that werewolf over this way as well? He is. So I think we're going to target this one first. For obvious reasons, I would like to get rid of the Dauntless, as well as remove a Claw player. And they're also his fastest players, so it's pretty good to remove them. But that makes it a little bit more difficult, because this Guard we can't remove, so I probably will blitz him with Scar instead of Underbite. Okay, let's see. So we can have these here. And I think I'm going to leave Twitchy off the pitch for this. Or maybe, no, let's leave him on. He's still very useful, but where is he? Luke Fu is going to go on the pitch. Let's put both of them back here. And is that fine? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blitz. Yeah, I think so. So yeah, this is good. Let's see what happens. Quick snap. I get to move. Perfectly fine with that. Let's see, put you there. These two are obviously going to move up a space. And these are just going to stay where they are. I could move them one over. I think that's actually not a bad idea. At least like this. So confirm that. Set up some safety first. And let's see, that's 4, 5, 6. I can't get a 3 dice against the werewolf, but that's not a big problem. So let's just start with the blitz right away. It's the most important block that we can do and will do this turn. So I'd really like to get the knockdown. Oh. It's a stun. It's at least a decent start. No complaints here. I could actually try to foul him if I want to. But I don't think that's worth it yet. Okay, next up will be our blocks here. And I obviously won't follow those because of the flesh golems. Even though I would kind of like to stay next to those guys, it's just not worth the backlash we would get from that. So that is a two dice right now. Which means I can put Olkoth to here. That is still okay. Let's set ourselves up a little bit of a screen right there. Yeah, I'm fine with this. And I'm going to go for the pickup last, because we are going to do this three dice next, which works as well. And stay. Okay, so far so good. Do I want to put up a threat with Luke Thu? Probably not. We're just going to move him back over here and do that. Okay, that's a pickup failure, and we're not going to reroll that. It's just not worth it. He can, in theory, get a tackle zone on the ball, or even two, but it's going to be pretty difficult to do so. And so we can afford to not pick up the ball this turn and just leave it like that. Oh, and I should not forget that he has a wizard. I did forget that in the first turn already. So if he could have gone for a lot of damage with a fireball here, so I need to be careful there. Need to be very careful about that. Let's see, so what can he do? Looks like he wants to blitz Scar over here. Probably with this white. Although he should do it with the werewolf because of Claw. And he can reach that with the werewolf, but that would giving up this side quite a bit, and I do want to move down that way. So I don't know, we'll see what he does here. But it looks like he wants to blitz this. And he really should, because otherwise I'm going to hit this ghoul. Oh, not the werewolf. I might hit the ghoul anyways, in all honesty, because he was so nice to put him next to us, and even if he knocks me down, well, depending on where he pushes us and if he follows or not, I might not be able to. But this is a good target to have available. Okay. So either one of those is going to get the block that he wants. Question is, which one of us, of these two? Nope, really can't afford that, buddy. So they have movement four, so 1, 2, 3, 4, he could get him to here, if he wants to. That is still fine as well, and it's actually pretty helpful, because we can get the knockdowns there. Wow. So this is going to, he's going to blitz with him over there. Yep, that's what I assumed he would do. And we go down. With a stun. That's okay. He's probably going to move back. There it is. So I won't be able, oh, does he want to do the going for it? He does. Okay, so first things first, we do have the two dice right here, with Frenzy. Next up, this is a two dice as well, because we have Guard, thanks to Stand Firm. It doesn't do anything though. see, that's better. And I'll push him over to there and follow. Because he will just move in anyways, and we might as well make the progress there. Not really sure yet on where to blitz this though, so we probably want to blitz with him. That's just a push, but I can work with that, I think. Let's put him up there and stay. And I'm going to go next to the ghoul, maybe, or do we want to move over here? Because I didn't get the knockdown, it makes things more difficult. So let's go next to the ghoul. Put some pressure on that. And so this would be a 2 dice. This is a 1 dice right now that we can make into a 2 dice. The problem here is the fear of the bad roll. Especially with the Crocs. But we'll see. So the Crocs will be next, and I will do that. So there's the Bonehead. That's not what we wanted to see. And let's see about the pickup. Okay, worked this time. That's a lot better. And where do we want to go? Probably nowhere this turn. Or even back a bit. Can put ourselves right here, and then 1, 2, there. Well, let's see. Against the knockdown here. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, he's good there, I think. The problem with the Bonehead, we lose the tackle zone, so if he knocks down this Saurus, he has an open spot for his werewolf to run through and blitz through. He still needs to remove that first, but that's doable. Okay, now he's made it pretty difficult for him. He still has dodged on the werewolf, so he might dodge here if he gets the knockdowns. But we'll see. So the good thing here is this guy is currently surfable. And if he doesn't blitz here, we will push him out next turn. The downside about this is I probably need to blitz here to do that, because otherwise I will get surfed consequently in the next turn. And we don't want that. So that's a tad difficult to achieve right now. And I'd say he probably knows what he's doing. His team record so far is speaking for itself. Oh, interesting. Hoping for the defender down. Yeah, I'm just going straight back, my friend. So I probably won't serve this guy as much as I would like to, because we do have the option to hit this guy. Although, I don't know. He's got his guard player in position now, so that makes things more difficult. But I'll probably end up switching sides here anyways. So I'm not sure yet how to do this. This is a 1 dice or a dodge. Okay, he's choosing the dodge. That's the right choice to make. And let's see about this. So he needs to stand up. Put him down. Oh. Okay, just stunned, but still perfectly fine. So what are our options? I'd still like to serve this guy. That's a 1 dice right now, yes? Yes. Okay, I have an idea how to do it, but it's not the safest thing to do in all likelihood. So I'm not sure if it's worth it or not. Let's see. So first we are going to switch sides, and I do have a lot of room to work with here, and Twitchy is very fast, so that is not a very big problem. And how we're going to achieve this is by dodging Shogath to over here, because he's got sidestep, so he is actually not in danger of getting served. And then I can push him out. And there we go. Injury, that's good. And now all we need is no regeneration. And that's no regeneration. Perfect. Okay, and we can move Underbite to over here. And still have a decent block right there. So this is not going to knock this guy down, but it's just pushing him away so that he can't make use of his claw that easily. Which is fine enough for me. Yeah, let's take this one, and I'm going to stay. I'd like to be able to move him around a bit. Both of those stuns are really good though, right now. And last but not least, we can go for the block here, and let's go for the Flesh Golem. Yep, that's going to be Stand Firm, so no movement there. But still, it activates Oryx again, and he has his Tackle Zone back. And his Guard Assist, of course. So the Flesh Golem actually has a 2 dice against block only right now. So this worked pretty well, I'd say. We do have Mighty Blow against this Flesh Golem, probably. We do have our Mighty Blow right here to go after a Ghoul. Maybe. Once again, it depends. He'll probably move them, but he needs to put himself in my way. Oh, he could theoretically blitz me, apparently. Yep. With a dodge and 2 going for it, he can get a 2 dice. That's not his wrestle guy, though, so he would need a POW. And that's a 3 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus, and then a 1 in 6 chance. Not that good. Okay, brings in the guard in the perfect position, so he can go for either of these, but I assume he's going to go for Xezanoth. Okay, that's good. We do get our... Oh... So is he going to blitz there? But that's not a... He doesn't really have a good way of blitzing here. Well, he could get an assist here. Okay, he's just moving players in. That's not a problem right now. And if we can get a block against this werewolf, that would be pretty good. Okay, that's the first going for it. Let's see. Oh, there's the first one. He's probably going to reroll that, though. He has 4 rerolls. But I doubt he will do the second one because of that. He's still fast enough to cover the entire ground here. Yeah, literally. So it's 8 spaces to the side here. Oh, he really goes for it. Let's see how that turns out. And he falls down. Okay, nice. So not ideal, but certainly far from bad. Okay, let's set up some sort of safety here, and that is putting Shogath next to this guy. I'm probably going to end up blitzing him, but we do need to do some other stuff first. Like hitting this werewolf. I really like to... Yeah, let's try to set up a serve. But we do get the stun to begin with, which is good enough for us right now. And let's see. I'd really like to blitz from here, although it doesn't really matter how I do this. All that matters is that I push him backwards. Okay, no knockdown, but still perfectly decent. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if I go all the way over there, I can't do anything. But the question is, do I want that? Right now, the answer to that would be no. Can I actually... We could get Nectalios on there. Yeah, let's take some weird risks. So he's not really protected anymore. And this is a two dice. So we can just get the serve here sooner or later if possible. And I still am going to take the knockdown though. And I know I could have made it that we could have kept the two dice there, and I decided against it in the end. Okay, so this is a bit of a gamble right now. So I'm going to put Nectalios on here because he's got type in tackle, and this guy is his preferred blitzer probably, still. But this guy would be good as well. And I could have put Nectalios to here, but I will try to knock free Daoloth, which didn't work. And so I'll have to do this differently. Because I keep not getting knockdowns against this guy. And so I'm going to risk doing this. And it didn't work. Oh crap, that's not good. So, I'm not very protected right now. And that might cost me. He might go for a wizard, actually. So I assume he's going to blitz with the ghoul because of that. The problem with him not getting knocked down is that we have a lot of our heavy hitters over here and not where we need them. But if he does that, I have diving tackle. Did he not notice that? That's not a blitz. So that's actually perfectly fine right now. And if that dodge works, we can't do too much about it, but it's... okay, no diving tackle. So let's see what he does here. Good enough, unfortunately. Really not what I wanted to see happen there. And that even less so. Okay, that's not good. The upside about this right now is... you really want to do that? You can't really reach there. Is we do have a block here to get there, and that could help. Yeah, they really didn't want to do that. Okay, I like that turnout. So I'm going to keep Underbite over here, even though it's probably a bit of a waste, unfortunately. But there is not too much we can do about that. So... how do we play this? That's the big question right now. This guy, I'm just going to push and stay. Because I'd need to stay next to the werewolf there. Which means Sesanoth needs to go over this way. Nuctelios needs to go there. And then the Blitz is next, unfortunately. With the going for it, let's see what we can do here. And even a both down would work, because he's got Wrestle. Oh, crud. That's not good. That really is not what I want to see here. So I need to dodge like this. Let's see, what is next? I could move him over, which would probably help. But I'm not completely sure about that. Let's not follow here. And maybe... let's see, if I knock him down, we can move him up to here to keep this guy locked down. Yeah, let's try that. Nope, I keep pushing the Flesh Golem. It's just not working. Ah, finally, but he will just stand back up and then I'm where I started with this. I should probably move away from this, but he could get the player there, and I can't really do that, or don't really want to do that. So I'm going to leave it as it is. And let's see what he does with this now. We do have Diving Tackle on him, which is pretty nice. And if he blocks me, he will run into a one dice on the second one, assuming he doesn't knock us down on the first one. So this was a risk that didn't pay off because the dodge over here didn't work. And so I probably should have done that a little bit differently. But oh well. Let's just hope that I can get the ball back before this half is over, or I'll be a little bit annoyed with myself. Because there's no one else to blame but me. As always. There comes the dodge. Maybe? He did stand up this werewolf, though, which is pretty nice, so we can get a block against him and or just surf him, maybe, if I put the effort in. We can push him here, then put a player there and push him out with this guy. And we would have two assists for that in that case. So I'm all for that scenario. Okay, there we go. Get the dodge. Doesn't get the knockdown, but he can push me to here, and that just means he doesn't have to deal with the diving tackle. Still means it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and he can't get that far. Let's see what the going for it does. It makes it. Oh, really? Oh, I completely missed that guy down there. When did he move him down there? If he makes that now. I don't like that. Inaccurate pass. Oh, God. That is horrible. When did he move him down there? I completely missed that. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, crap. I completely missed that. That was stupid. Oh, come on. Oh, God, I'm so annoyed with myself right now. I can't believe I missed that. And I cannot reach him. It's not possible. So I won't score. He will score on me. Crap. That is so bad. Why did I do that? And then I don't even get this. Oh boy. So, not my brightest moment, I'd say. I'm sorry for everyone that has to live with that stupidity on my behalf. Oh, come on. How could I be that blind? I completely missed that he moved him down there. So I cannot reach him. It's not possible. But I can at least still try to hurt his werewolves. There we go. And I am in the market for fouling now, actually. Maybe at least, yeah. Problem is, I still kind of need to try and reach him down there. The problem is, I would like to blitz with him, or foul with him, but getting him there is a little bit difficult. So I'm probably going to go with that with Twitchy, because we can afford to lose him now. I think. Yeah, still try to get this wrestle ghoul. Not good enough, unfortunately. Let's do this one first. I really hate the stand firm, to be honest. Let's see. Nah, just stunned. That's not worth it. So you might argue that this was a little bit of a salty foul, but I still think getting the chance to remove one of the werewolves was a decent chance. The problem here was that I wanted to block this and then move down here. But if I move him here, he's just going to score and that's not going to help me. And he can just move here or there and I won't be able to follow him regardless of this. So the first half is a pretty much a bust and it's my own fault. And now all I can try is to damage his team and hope that we can get a decent turnout for us for the second half. And that also still includes surfing this guy, if possible. But he just goes down. Oh! Wow, I actually did get an armor break there. Didn't show. But he regenerates. Ah, unfortunate for us. Would have liked a different turnout there. Yeah, so now I really can't follow this. But I can still foul. Although I probably should at least try to still remove some of his players, so let's go with Underbite for the mighty blow chance. Let's see, nothing. Okay, so these two... This guy doesn't have block, so we'll start with him. And then we can go for another foul. I still have two reserve players, so I'm fine doing this. Or one after this. And this time it's with a skink that doesn't have a skill. Oh, it's another double. So I'm going to get sent off, I think. Yep, there it is. And it's only a KO. And he has two babes, so it's very likely that the player is going to come back. If he wants to make sure of that, he's going to score now. But I'm not sure he will. Because if he scores now, he gets two KO chances, obviously. That's what this comes down to. I'm still very much annoyed with myself that I completely missed that guy and that I put myself in a position where that could happen. So I'm really not happy with this. I apologize. I should be better than that. As stupid as that sounds. And rolling two fouls with two doubles is also pretty unfortunate. But at least I will still be able to field 11 players after this. So let's just try to deal a little bit more damage. Oh, another injury. Please stay out. Nope. Once again, regeneration works. I hate regeneration teams. Did I mention that already? I may have mentioned that once or twice. And I won't go for more fouls, so let's try to get a three dice here. Can I make that? Maybe. Let's try to remove this first. Finally. Yost down on the first one. Let's see, so that's 5, 6, 7, 8, so one more, and then we're up to 9. And now that's a 3 dice. Good enough. Oh, just a stun. And I need 2 assists to make this a 3 dice. And we can get those as well. Oh, will he go for a wizard now? I've forgotten about the wizard again. I'm not very happy about that. That would be a supreme way of trying to hit 5 of the Sorai plus the Crocs. Oh boy. Did I make a even bigger mistake? He might be considering it. Nope, he's scoring. Okay. So he earned that because of my own stupidity. That really should not have happened. Okay. KO comes back, unfortunately. So both of the fouls were pretty meaningless. That makes me a bit sad right now. So let's see about that. I probably want to switch these. Him there like this and that. And then we'll put a normal one on this outside. But with diving tackle in place. So I need to do this. No, wait. I actually need to set up like this. And let's hope that that will work. And move this in. Okay, yeah, that works for me. I can't stress enough how annoyed I am with myself. I mean, you could argue that this was just a pretty bad position again, because once he knocked me down, the ball scattered onto the ghoul and he caught it right away. And then I knocked down the ghoul and the werewolf caught it right away, which is just the 1 in 8 chance that it scatters onto the exact exact space where the werewolf is, and also that he's able to catch it even though he was in a tackle zone. There's nothing I can do about that, but I'm going to call a little bit of not my fault on that at least. I still should have noticed the ghoul down there, and I didn't, and that's on me. So I take full responsibility for that, but in terms of getting put into that position. That was very unlikely to happen, and it still did, and there's nothing I can do about that. So I have to live up to that anyways. And that doesn't change anything. So how about a perfect defense now? Because he was so nice to go very aggressive. And I rarely get a perfect defense where I can really make use of our opponent doing that. Or a blitz would be the same. Oh, okay. No complaints here. I'm kind of happy about that. So, how do we do this? We put him over there. And I will go very aggressive here now, because I feel like I need to. I'm going to do this move last though, but let's still put him there to begin with. And this is not ideal because I want to set up the serve. But there's not much we can do about that right now, so that's still okay by my standards. Problem is I need to dodge or do going for it to get there. So I'm going to do this going for it first. To get a Saurus on that. Which is very important. And these guys are in a bit of a pickle, I'd say. So let's put Dahl up to here. And I do need a Skink here as well, unfortunately, just to remove this. Which I don't necessarily like, but I won't get around it. And then we can start to go in. So let's do this. And I fail my dodge again. That's the second skink dodge that I do. And the second one that fails. That's a pretty bad average. Double ones as well. At least I didn't injure myself. And he can't get that too easily. And I still have at least one skink back here to work with. I would have moved him up as well to try and get him next to this werewolf if possible. But it wasn't, so let's see what he does with this. Looks like he wants to blitz with that guy, which isn't necessarily a bad idea, but maybe the dodge will fail and he doesn't have dodge on this player yet. So it might take up a reroll. There comes the blitz. Maybe. Yep, there it goes. Oh, okay, that's at least a reroll gone. With the possibility of a turnover. And it is a turnover, wow. That is so good for us. Okay. Time to deal with this. Let's see. This guy goes down, we'll follow. Oh, nice, an injury. That's a player gone. Might regenerate though, and he does. So regeneration really working for him. 3 out of 4 times so far. And in terms of blitzing, I'd really like to blitz this guy, but we can just block him. So we're going to do that. Oh, and we actually get the knockdown. That's even better. Let's follow. Okay, the blitz is probably allowing us to turn this around quite significantly. Let's do this for the diving tackle, even though it puts us a bit at risk. Then we're going to blitz this werewolf, and I think I am going to blitz him down here because we want him to not be near the ball or be able to dodge around this way easily. That's a push, but we do have frenzy, so I get a second try. Still a push. Still not over yet, though. Maybe. Well, I might want to go after his line of scrimmage. possibly. Okay, that's our reroll gone. But it did accomplish what it was supposed to. Which was allowing me to get a player here. Let's see, where do I actually want to put him? If I manage to pick up the ball, I'm going to go here, which means the ball, the skink needs to be there. Okay. Yeah, so we're going to do this. I'm giving up control on the line of scrimmage a bit. Because I want this guy to not be able to follow us once again that easily. So now we have a two dice here. And I'll take the both down, actually. It makes dodging for him worse. So let's try the pickup. Okay, nice. Oh, he still has the wizard. Still need to stay back here. That doesn't change that now. So what do we go for here? Probably this guy. Because he doesn't have guards. No. Okay, we need to go for this one. Okay, nice. That worked. So push him over there, and I'm going to stay. It puts Sesanov in a very bad position. Once he stands up, he has a decent block here, I think. But it keeps Oryx in a safe position to still help with his guard. So I like that. Oh, there goes the wizard. And down goes him, stun, and just a knockdown. He stood up one of his players first. That's the same mistake I did once. Oh, he stood up one of his players first, and that ended his turn. That is beautiful. Oh, that is so good for us. Yeah, I'll keep pushing him, actually. Just allows him to get him, allows us to get him further away from all of this, and I might get the knockdown at some point. Yeah, let's put him down there and follow. Okay, let's see. Do the mighty blow thing. And follow. And I still need to protect the ball. So we'll blitz up here. And here all I need is a both down or a defender down. We don't get any of that. Stay. And move back next to this guy. So the problem is we still can't protect this very well, so I think I need to try and pick up the ball with Shogath. Ideally, because he has block sidestep. So I feel okay with having him a little bit more exposed. Okay, so how do I play this? The problem is this guy. I can't protect myself completely, that's the problem. So what we're going to do is we're going to go here, which leaves us exposed to this guy. We'll put Mctalius to there, so he can't dodge easily, and this guy can't dodge easily as well, which is the entire idea behind that. And then hopefully we can get this knockdown. We indeed can. Will he take the stand firm? He does. But it does allow me to bring in Olkoth up here. And that should make this a one dice for him. I won't go for the going for it, which I could use to get up there. But we'll leave it like this. So, what's remaining here? Yeah, that's the only two dice we have, so we'll take it with a push. Not ideal, but okay. Let's follow. And there we go. So I will score next turn, if possible. The problem is, we will be at the same position as before that, because everything I injure regenerates so far. Ideally, we will get another injury before this happens, though. But if I want to win this, I need to score next turn. And it just leaves me no wiggle room here in any of this. So we are going to do that. Let's see. This guy does have dodge, so he can get away. Possibly. Let's see if his dodge rolls start to go down the same path as mine have. And he fails again. I wouldn't mind that. So the wizard was weird. So we got lucky that he did get two knockdowns, which is a 50% per player. But we can still be happy that he only knocked down one and stunned the other, but didn't KO or injure any of ours. So the outcome could have been a lot worse with that. So the thing is, I'd really like to try and serve something. That's a one dice. That's a turnover. That's a knockdown. Once again, not the result I was hoping for. And that makes it once again even worse. Come on, please don't. Okay, I at least have a tackle zone on the ball still. And if he wants to dodge that way, down he goes. Okay, that's a KO. Good. So I think I might actually want to play this as a tie now, because it's starting to get riskier and riskier. And it depends a little bit on what happens this turn now. Let's see, yeah, that's just a knockdown, and I'm going to take that over everything. The thing is, I can get a serve here. Going to go for that, but I need to move my players over first. Let's actually put him here, not next to anybody, so in case something goes wrong on my end, I'm still able to work with that. So if I do blitz him like this, we don't get to serve him because we just knock him down. Okay, works as well. Not quite as well as I wanted to, but I probably still should not complain. And let's see, we will push him to here, so let's put Nyarakath to there, or Nyarakath. And let's see, how close are you? Still the best bat we have, I guess, so just set up for safety now and not go for the block so far. Okay, that's better for him than for me, I think. Yeah, these are all bad. So this could still turn into a bit of a unfortunate situation. I don't know why I struggle this much right now. I really shouldn't. Let's go for the zombie, mainly because he's easier to injure. Then the flesh golems. But these are one dice blocks. And I don't want to do those. I really like to pick up the ball, but we can't afford to, so we're not going to. Problem is, if he knocks this guy down, he can bring in his guarder. So who knows what will happen. And I have to be honest, I might actually be fine to just play this down to a draw. Because I couldn't score now as fast as I had planned. And that just makes it more likely that he will score again after this. So I might do this as much as it's a bit of a cop-out. Because I usually like to play to win and not to draw. But I'd still take it over the loss. That's good, though. It's not good that he gets the knockdown, obviously, but it's good that he does get the both down, so he's not moving. And so he will either try a risky dodge or just stay there and I can surf him next turn. Oh, wow, really? And he makes it without a reroll? That's a surprise. That failed, so that's a turnover. Okay. Let's see, so he put himself there, so I'm just going to... But he's probably so far away. Is that really worth it? Not completely sure. Let's put him down there and stay for now. So I'm trying to figure out a way in which I can serve this guy. It's definitely possible. Question is how easy. So if I do this, and then we'll blitz from here. Okay, just trying to figure out a different way, but it didn't really work. So I'm still fine with this. He's just out. Stand up. So this is three dice already? It is. And I'm fine with taking that. With the knockdown preferably, of course. Oop, no stun though. Or no KO or injury, that's how I wanted to say this. So I should probably try to pick up the ball now. Because at some point I need to. Okay, thank you. So I can move up there. So this is probably going to end in a tie now, because I will stall this out, if possible. Keep the push. And these are all still one dice. Yep, so I can't really afford to take those. Yeah, so I'm going to stall this until the end, if possible. I really should have been able to dominate this with the amount of injuries that I've gotten, but it just didn't happen because of regeneration, which is the strong part of the... It's an important factor for these teams, of course. I think I've injured, what, 4 or 5 of his players in total? And all but one came back. So he at least managed 3 regeneration wells. That I remember. 3 out of 4, that's what I said a while ago. But I'm not sure if he did more since then. Maybe 1? I really don't know. Yeah, so he's still trying to get close. And this makes this a one dice right now, but... yeah, it's going to stay that, or he's just going to dodge away. I don't like the waiting for opponent. I hope that doesn't turn into a disconnect problem. Let's see. Nope, there he's back. And there goes the dodge, so this time he does make it. Yeah, okay, he's going in for the going for it here quite a bit. Oh, he really... that dodge is... I understand why he wants to do that, because it would maybe force me to score here. He needs to reroll this. Yeah, we'll take the both down. Thank you very much. Okay, so the important stuff first. And that is putting Yalagorth up there. Probably, actually, Nectalius. I could put Nectalius here. No, we need him there. I actually need him here, I think. Because if he blitzes with him, he's going to be able to go there afterwards, and that I don't want. But I can at least, well... that's going for it, so we'll do that later. Let's blitz here first. Good. Very good. Stay, please. And then we'll do the going for it, which will just make it impossible for him to reach us without dodging a lot. And that leaves us with two blocks, so let's go for this one. Just a push, as always. Or it's actually three, so we can try to get the mighty blow right there. Oh, hello. Haven't seen those in a while, but it's still fine, I think. And yeah, just push him over there. Even though it's going to move us further away from that, with Frenzy we won't be able to disengage anyways. Oh, wow. That's unfortunate. But at least for now, we are still in a good position. But he's really doing a good job, so... I think he definitely is... an experienced player to some degree. So we're both down to one reroll, and I need to stall this for three more turns. Maybe, maybe not. Promise, my really good players are still down here, so these two, and I won't be able to get them away from there. It's just not going to happen. So I might be forced to score here a little bit faster than I want to. Because if there's the chance that he can attack me, I will not let him. Okay, he's taking the boat down. That's still fine, though. It means the werewolf won't move this turn. Okay, he's just standing that gap. So who is he going to blitz with? Possibly the flesh golem? Although, no. That doesn't really work for him. It's a one dice. Might still do it, because it would allow him to start moving him over there. And he does. Okay. Gets the knockdown as well. So he's not going to follow this. And then he can go to there. Yep, makes sense. Okay. Let's see. So the important thing first, which is this blitz. And yes, I am doing that as a blitz. And let's see, I should have stood up my player first. So I'm trying to set if I want to be... Yeah, we're just going to put him there. Stay. Oh, nice. That stun is pretty good. Allows me to put Dialoth right there. Or actually, we will just leave them where they are, I think. Just move him one space in. Let's see. Defender down? Nope, just a push. Still fairly decent thing to happen. Not sure about the follow here, to be honest. Because he might be able to dodge around and surf. Let's see. KO, so now we can move him up. Probably won't help us too much anymore, but you never know. And this one I will stay as well. So let me think. I think it's probably actually better to just go here and put him to there. Or to here. No, there is fine. Yep, let's do that. If only I had tackle. Things we still have diving tackle on this guy. And that's pretty important. And this is, once again, only a one dice right now. So we'll see. Okay, that is something we can work with. Wrestle, okay, we're both going down. Which means he will dodge with this well. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, yeah. So that's a going for it already. Ah, he gets the knockdown. But he can't reach me. Still KOs me. But he can't reach the ball carrier. Oh, something down here. Oh, you jerk. So now we can move the zombie in to here, or there, or just anywhere next to Scar, if he wants to. Okay. Let's go here, so that the white won't be able to just move. And I think it should be fairly obvious what I would like to do. Because I'd like to really serve this guy. But I'm worried about this. Honestly, you need to stand up first. Let's just hope. Good enough. So out he goes, assuming I don't roll double skulls or anything like that. Nope, there is a push in there. Okay, good enough. I think. See about this. We have this set up. He will just stand up, so we are still next to the ghoul. Flesh golem goes down. Oh, he's considering for once not using stand firm. And he does let me do this, so I'm still just going to push him and stay. I do still have this block down here. Push him up there. Stay, please. And then let's see. Yeah, I'll leave him there. So not what I usually go for, but it felt necessary this time to secure that I won't lose. I'm okay with this outcome. So no level ups, I think, at least not yet. We might get an MVP somewhere that could change that. So I hope that will be the case, and that's basically the only thing I can go for. And that's why I was considering moving him, because if he actually makes it there, as unlikely as it is, he could serve me. But let's just assume that he doesn't. He has a reroll, so this doesn't mean anything yet, but it's the first dodge already. Okay. That was it. And I'm not going to take any stupid risks, and we'll just score this. So, here we go. He definitely did a good job there, and even though I still think, despite my mistake, that I should have scored in the first half, and that it was a pretty unique situation once again that made that possible for him, it still was my fault that he had the option to begin with. Okay, no level ups whatsoever, I think, but a lot of... Well, let's see. Wait, oh yeah, a bunch of injuries happened through serfs, so I actually only injured 3. So this, if you want to call that only. But yeah, still decent, we at least didn't lose. And that's fine for now. So yeah, that is where we're going to end the episode for today. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more Blood Bowl 2, just subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time, and have a nice day. Bye.